students or children will see no change in bus and train fares, whether they pay in cash or by EasyLink. Adult commuters paying cash, however, will see a 10-cent increase per trip. But if they opt for the EasyLink, they'll see a smaller increase of 2 cents per journey. For example, a commuter who travels by bus and train from Sembawang Road to Newton MRT station now pays $1.53. This will go up to $1.55 with the new fares. Senior citizens using concession cards will see fares go up by 1 cent per journey. So a senior citizen who makes the same trip will pay 87 cents instead of 86 cents. But from October, concession hours for them will be extended to the whole day throughout the week. Their fares on the Northeast and Circle Lines will also go down. It's estimated that 4 in 10 senior citizens will save on fares. Overall, the Public Transport Council said the majority of commuters will see an average increase of 15 cents more per week. The council added the 1% adjustment is significantly less than the maximum 2.8% that the two public transport operators had asked for.
We are also aware in the recent months, recent weeks, inflation has crept up. We've been receiving feedback from commuters about various things. And we are hard-pressed to say that we should award the full 2.8%. After taking everything in balance, we decided to cap it at 1%.
SMRT is also dangling more carrots to better distribute crowds during morning peak hours at train stations. It currently offers a 10-cent discount for commuters who exit from designated stations within the city area before 7:30 a.m. But this will be tripled to 30 cents and the time extended to before 7:45 a.m. Well, to help the needy cope with the fare adjustment, the government and the public transport operators have set aside some $4 million to fund some 200,000 public transport vouchers. Application for these vouchers begins next month.